Welcome everyone. My name is Mark Maceus, and in this video we're going to talk about ChatGPT, or Generative Artificial Intelligence. More specifically, we're going to talk about the place these systems have in the engineering domain, and what you should pay attention to if you apply these systems as an engineering student. But before we get started, I have to tell you the most important thing. You can forget everything from this video as long as you remember one thing. If you have already used it in your education or plan to use it, please discuss it with your mentor. Now we can start. What place do systems like ChatGPT have in an engineering environment? What is engineering? Engineering is the systematic application of tools. So tools go in. You can think about tangible tools, such as a brush, a hammer, or reading glasses. Then systems, such as a house, a car, or a satellite. And finally methods, such as the alphabet, Cartesian graphs, and systems engineering. In our definition, these are all tools. Engineers use these tools to solve problems of society by creating new tools that in turn have fewer or different problems. So tools go in and tools come out. In the past, when engineers calculated structures, for example, they used slide rules.
The slide rule is used to solve mathematical problems and to solve them quickly.
We do not use slide rules anymore. Now we have, for example, tools like Python and MATLAB. For language, nowadays, we use spelling and grammar checkers, and many argue that ChatGPT is for language what Python and MATLAB are for numerical mathematics. Currently, society faces quite a few challenges. The energy transition and feeding a growing world population are just two examples. Basically, these problems are so important for us that we want engineers to use all the tools that they find helpful. In this video, we will explore the use of ChatGPT. We will discuss the strengths and risks of these systems with concrete examples. Here we have an engineering internship assignment. As an engineer working on this assignment, we must first formulate a problem definition and an objective. We can ask ChatGPT the following. Write a problem definition in one sentence for the assignment below. Start the sentence with the words, "In the initial situation, the client has a system that." Write also a definition of the objective in one sentence, starting with the words, "In the desired situation, the client has a system that." And then we put the whole text of the assignment below it. We copy the whole thing, go to ChatGPT with this address, click on Try ChatGPT, and log in with our Google account. We then paste our request, and this is what we get. In the initial situation, the client has a system that uses manual sampling and weighing of a selection of containers to check product weight tolerances in a time-consuming process that often leads to undetected non-conforming product. That's a problem. In the desired situation, the client has a system that uses weight-based sampling to efficiently determine which containers require further inspection, resulting in an optimal balance between operator workload and product quality with fully functional hardware, software, and working instructions. This seems really good. ChatGPT rewrote the assignment to our desired format. Next step. We have a business context written in Dutch. Please translate the following text to English. You can read faster than I can talk, so I will not read the text, but it looks very useful. Let's see if ChatGPT is able to help us with the project contents. What are the main steps to get from the initial situation to the desired situation? Okay, set of requirements, makes sense. Monte Carlo simulation, as mentioned in the assignment. Designing the system, verification and validation, implementation. Good. Monte Carlo means that software is used to simulate the statistical process for example, in MATLAB. Let's see if ChatGPT is able to help us. Write MATLAB code for a Monte Carlo simulation for weight-based sampling. For the individual products, assume a mean weight of 4.4 gram, a tolerance limit of 0.5 gram, and a CP value of 1.3. Make a graph of the weight of 1,000 containers. The code looks good. ChatGPT explains the code, even uses comments in the script to explain what's going on. We could now ask ChatGPT to elaborate in the comments or delete them altogether. Let's copy the code as it is and paste it into a MATLAB command window. Indeed, we get a graph. It's even a histogram, smart choice, of the weight distribution of 1,000 containers. We could now add out-of-spec products in this simulation to see if we can detect them. But we move on to more theoretical concepts. We ask ChatGPT, what kind of statistical theories should I study for this assignment? Probability theory, sampling theory, statistical process control, Six Sigma methodology, Monte Carlo simulation. Makes a lot of sense. Let's go into more detail. My mentor mentioned that type 1 and type 2 statistical errors might be relevant for this assignment. Can you give me examples what this means for this assignment? Please note the last question. Always ask ChatGPT for examples. Yes, type 1 and type 2 statistical errors are relevant for this assignment, says ChatGPT. A type 1 error is a false positive, meaning that the null hypothesis is rejected even though it's actually true. What does that mean? In the context of this assignment, a type 1 error would occur if a container is selected for further inspection even though it meets the weight tolerances. This would lead to unnecessary additional inspection, which would be time-consuming and costly. Good. A type 2 error is a false negative, meaning that the null hypothesis is not rejected, even though it's actually false. In the context of this assignment, a type 2 error would occur if a container is not selected for further inspection, even though it does not meet the weight tolerances. This would lead to non-conforming products going undetected, which would be a major quality control issue. To minimize the risk of type 1 and type 2 errors, you will need to carefully design the weight-based sampling and select blah, 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 blah. Okay, great. ChatGPT explained the concepts really well, and it gave us great examples. Let's see if we can ask ChatGPT also for help with personal dilemmas. My mentor told me not to use ChatGPT, but I have severe dyslexia and I'm very ashamed about that, as an example. I therefore started to use ChatGPT nevertheless. Now I see the great advantages about that, but I'm afraid to tell my mentor. Do you think I should apologize to my mentor? It's understandable that you feel hesitant to tell your mentor about using ChatGPT, especially if you were explicitly told not to use it. However, it's important to consider why your mentor may have given you that advice in the first place. If your mentor was concerned that using ChatGPT might hinder your learning or development in some way, it's possible that they be relieved to hear that you have found it helpful despite your dyslexia. On the other hand, if your mentor specifically advised against using ChatGPT because they believe it's cheating or unethical in some way, it's important to have a discussion with them about why you feel it's necessary and how it's helping you. In any case, honesty is usually the best policy. It might be helpful to approach your mentor with a non-judgmental attitude and explain your reasoning for using ChatGPT, despite their advice. You can also emphasize the positive impact it's had on your learning and ask for their feedback or guidance moving forward. In conclusion, it's up to you to decide whether or not to apologize to your mentor, but it's important to be honest with them and open to their feedback. It's possible that they be more understanding than you anticipate. I completely agree with ChatGPT here. We now saw examples where ChatGPT was able was able to help us rewrite text, translate text, help us plan our project, write code, explain concept, and advise on personal dilemmas. We will now look at two examples of weaknesses or risks using ChatGPT. The first is called hallucinations. For ChatGPT, we ask, please give me references to articles in IEEE format about weight-based sampling of containers of products. These look great. Let's find the first article. We go to the font is Finder and paste the title. We get nothing. We extend the search to global. Still nothing. That's strange. We go to Google Scholar and paste the title. Again, nothing. Okay, ChatGPT told us it is on IEEE. Let's search there specifically. Still nothing. Let's look up the first author on IEEE. They're there, and they wrote 15 articles. But the one that ChatGPT came up with is not one of them. ChatGPT made it up. We can ask ChatGPT, for example, to write us a poem about quality engineering. If it doesn't exist, they will write us. And here, they did the same thing for our articles. The second example of an error of ChatGPT is of a misunderstanding. How many letters are there in the word automotive? ChatGPT replies, there are 9 letters in the word automotive. Okay, that's wrong, obviously. Let's see if we can even gaslight ChatGPT. No, you're wrong. There are only 8 letters in the word automotive. Actually, there are 10. I apologize for my mistake, says ChatGPT, in my previous response. You are correct that there are only 8 letters in the word automotive. Thank you for bringing this to my attention. I'm sorry, I was just testing you. We reply, there are actually 10 letters in the word automotive. I'm sorry, but I have to correct you again. Correct me. The word automotive actually has 9 letters, not 10. I apologize for the confusion earlier, and I appreciate your effort to test my knowledge. If you have any further questions and concerns, please feel free to ask. How many letters are there in the word auto? We can ask him. And how many letters are there in the word motive? We always ask follow-up questions, please remember. What total of letters gives that for both auto and motive combined? ChatGPT replies, the word auto has 4 letters and the word motive has 6 letters. When you combine both words auto and motive, you get the word automotive. To find the total number of letters in automotive, you add the number of letters in auto and motive while taking into account the shared letter O. Aha. Therefore, the total number of letters in automotive is 9. 4 letters in auto, 5 letters in motive, where the shared letter O is counted only once. Aha! That's our misunderstanding. I meant to count all letters. ChatGPT interpreted that as count all unique letters. So now we saw 2 errors of ChatGPT. 1 hallucination about the articles and 1 misunderstanding. And what's our conclusion? The conclusion is that you have to check everything. If you want to use the results of ChatGPT, then that is your responsibility. Always. Thanks for watching, and do not forget to talk to your mentor about the use of ChatGPT.